We'll reconvene or we'll bring the regular meeting to order, commencing at, it's 7:55. This evening, we already had a town meeting and a public hearing, and we will progress on the regular meeting of the Board of Selectmen. Today's April 19th. We've already had the Pledge of Allegiance, so are there any additional agenda or consent items? I don't believe so. So delegations, would anyone like to speak to the commission this evening? Anyone? Okay. So there's the approval of the minutes.
I'll move to approve the Board of Selectmen public hearing minutes of April 5th, 2017, as submitted.
Second.
We have minutes approved and seconded. Any comments? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstain?
Abstain.
One abstention. There's another set of minutes?
Yes, I'll move to approve the minutes of the regular meeting of April 5th, 2017, as submitted.
Second.
It's been seconded. Any comments? I'm learning to slow down. Do you notice? That's for you, Mrs. Harden. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstain?
Abstain.
Abstain. Consent calendar.
Move to approve the consent calendar for the meeting of April 19th, 2017 in the amount of $2,071.89.
Second.
Any comments, questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstain? Terrific. We are, Mrs. Wilson is here tonight. She's our able, you're not Public Works, are you? You know, you're the senior center. Senior Center Director is here this evening. There's a short request to request money to be appropriated from the Para House account, and it's always nice to see every once in a while. So welcome.
Thank you. So Mark asked me to come this evening just to explain to the new board members what the Para House account is.
Great
and
idea.
It's a separate account that my commission oversees, and as well as the Board of Selectmen oversees. And it's someplace where if people want to donate money to the senior center, this is where it would be specifically for senior center use. Doesn't go into the general fund. For example, Marjorie Wilson passed away, and the family suggested in lieu of flowers do a donation to the senior center, so we've been receiving donations that way. We did have a gentleman a couple of years ago who passed away, was somebody that was a Meals on Wheels volunteer for us, did not really have an extended family, so he left some money in his will for us. So that's a nice way for members of the community to support the senior center and let us do things that operationally would be difficult for us to afford to do if we didn't have this other fund. So what my current request is because of the increased activity at the senior center, and if none of you have been to the offices, you know that we're sort of on top of each other. This is to sort of extend the office space to allow each person, myself, the program coordinator, and the administrative secretary, senior center associate, to have their own, like, really space, workspace, so that there is some, not so much privacy as quiet. So that's what this particular request is for. We're going to move Kristen Caramanica, who's a program coordinator, into what was currently, or what was, what is currently and what will become an office space. We need to drop some phone line and computer stuff and we've already purchased the desk. This request is for the purchase of the telephone and the rewiring from wherever in the building to our conference room. The request is a little bit high. I don't expect to spend this much money. However, with the building, I never want to underestimate the amount of what the work is going to cost, because inevitably it is more complicated than what we originally thought. So my hope is that it's just going to be a few hundred dollars, but this way I'm covered so that I don't have to come back and delay things in order to get this done.
And we know you're a good steward of that money. And I'm glad you got a chance to come tonight and give a little public service announcement for your Para House account. If people wanted to make those kind of in-kind donations or financial donations, they would contact the senior center and get the right wording for their wills or their
we'll be
or for
happy
their
to
memorials
explain
in the
that,
paper.
Yes.
That's it's what a great idea for people to do that so they can carry on. kind of pay it forward, if you will, or pay it behind at that point in your life. But wonderful.
And it's a nice way, you know, we have run, we run the gamut from having a rather large donation come from a gentleman's portion of his will to $50. Well, it doesn't matter to us if $50, $10, whatever, it all accumulates. So it's a nice way to keep money local and to know that you're helping local people. So
the money's never used for operational funds. That's a responsibility of the town and in your recreation account, etc.
Right.
So this is to enhance programming, enhance services at the senior center.
Or enhance actually the building.
The building itself,
right.
Which kind of helps the town out as well. Great. And you're not looking for luxurious executive suites. What you're trying to do is create professional space for professionals to do their work. And you're right, that you're literally on top of one another. And sometimes three conversations are going on at the same time.
There's always
in a very
three
small space. It'd be nice to separate that out and give people professional space. And privacy, frankly, some of your issues are delicate. So terrific. Are there any questions about Mrs. Wilson's
Can we have a motion on the floor before we have discussion?
Sure.
I'll move to approve an expenditure of up to $850 from the Powerhouse account to purchase an additional phone line and install a phone line in the conference room.
Second.
Okay. Are there any questions?
I have one question.
You want to go and then I'll go.
Mr. Salerno.
Just a question. The Powerhouse, the name of that, what's that? Is there a history for that?
So Roseanne probably knows it better than I do because this was prior. I mean, I know I've been here forever, but it was prior to me.
Okay.
Mr. Powerhouse was a chairman of the Commission on Aging.
Correct.
When the building was built, and I guess was instrumental in helping to get grants written and funding for the senior center portion of the community center. Mm-hmm. Am I getting that right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He served on the Commission on Aging for many years and was the chairman for several years, very active. And very active in setting up that portion of the building and what it would need.
Thank you.
Great question, Mr. Salerno. I did not know that either, so great. Mrs. Harding?
I guess that's why you need to keep me around.
Gladly.
Being familiar with Mr. Powerhouse and then the resulting donations that came in after his death, the intent of this is really to provide for the people who frequent the facility and to provide extra things that they might not be able to have. And so this I find a bit troubling because I don't think that we expect any other commissions to pay for their telephones, to pay for improvements to the building, or to pay for wiring. And even though this money is there, I think this is an operational expense, and I think that it's a responsibility of the town to pay for that. I don't really think that that was the intent of the Powerhouse account. I mean, when you think about it, we don't ask any of our other agencies to pay for their phones. I think it's a bad precedent to start, and I think Ms. Wilson for, you know, doing her best and being cost effective. It's not that I don't want them to have the phone. I don't think that that's an appropriate use of that money when we don't expect other agencies to do that.
At this particular point, the phone is going to be purchased out of my operation. The installation of the wires is right now not going to be. When I pulled this together, mm-hmm. it was about a month ago, and I was still trying to estimate how much money I was going to need between now and the end of the year for my office supplies. Since that time, I've been able to figure out that, yes, I can afford the phone out of the operation budget, but I just, without really understanding how much it's going to cost to do the wiring, I don't have $800 in my operation budget. And again, I don't expect it to be that much money, but as I was mentioning at a department head earlier this week, a project in the kitchen at the senior center, the community center, which I thought was going to be, you know, $800, is being quoted at $4,000. So it always feels like that the building has things up its sleeve that I'm not aware of, and it always seems like it's a bigger project to get something done that you think is really pretty simple. So.
Yeah, I mean, you bring up an interesting point, Mrs. Hardy. My comment might be that Mrs. Wilson might. These are small potatoes here, but the expansion and you also bought some furniture, and there's been a whole process here. And had you had that request, and we were going through the Board of Finance and looking to make improvements to the building, it might get in line, it might get in the queue, and it might take several years to get done, given our economic state and our very, very trim, efficient. But very trim budget right now. So
I would like to suggest that we take the money out of the contingency fund.
Okay. Comments on that?
Well, I'm always happy to defer it.
The contingency fund will delay this project at least by a month, given... Yeah, I know. That's my first thought. It's a great idea. My first thought is now you got to go to contingency, so it's got to go through the appropriations, including a town meeting or no? Anna, would that be a town meeting if it's $800 from a contingency?
If we have an appropriate budget account to transfer,
no, unless Joe has some in his telephone account or something, but no.
If I could make a suggestion here, Kathy, I can see some urgency in your voice here, and when you heard about a month, that something didn't sit with you, It's obvious that the need for this is because of the increased demands on your center by the people attending. I share Roseanne's concern that I don't want to start doing this. This is something that you shouldn't have to take funds set aside. I'd reluctantly say okay to this, but in the future, only because it does seem like it's urgent for you. I would like some type of I hate to say assurance because you can never say that, but next time or in the future, look to something of the contingency or something like that.
Can I make it?
Of course you can.
If the installation of the phone line is in the $200 range, then it's likely I can support it through my operations. I just, without knowing.
Like backup.
Right. Yeah. So I needed a safety net so that if, is a bigger deal than what I'm anticipating, then I have something in place to pay the bill. And I don't know if we can do that. I don't know if that's something that's workable that we can do.
I think you're 80% down the road on this project, and I think we need to let the project continue and to a final finish line. But I'd agree with Kevin. So in this case, I'd support this, and I know you're going to be diligent to try to get the money out of your operations and keep this a low price. But Mrs. Hardy, you're ex officio to the senior center,
yes,
custody agent. Why don't we, if because this has already gone through the Council on Aging and they've approved this. Let's create maybe some or remind them of the guidelines. You schooled us tonight on how this whole fund originated.
I don't think that the it's not that Ms. Wilson hasn't budgeted appropriately or anything.
No, of course
this
not.
Is an extra expense, and we talked earlier about, for instance, the need to replace the stove. And the need to replace this. And I don't think that's the town's cost of running the program. You know,
I know.
So I think that as I have a little bit of a dilemma with this, I think you've got the votes to pass it, but I'm going to abstain.
Okay. But let's maybe create some guidelines to give them some what we're thinking, if nothing else, give them the feedback.
I think
you do that anyway.
I think
your ex officio role. But I think you bring up an interesting point. I mean, but if you had to wait for the town to buy the stove, you know where we're at. And I know that Rotary and Lions are pitching in, and there's a lot of talk about the community coming together. And is that an enhancement? Probably not. Well, yeah, we're going to upgrade the stove, and we're going to upgrade the kitchen facilities. So maybe we do need a clear definition with that powerhouse, what the powerhouse money should be used for. There'll be some gray area always. You know, what's enhancement, what's operational, all of it's our responsibility. We have a senior center. We have a responsibility to the seniors, period, to put out a quality department and product to our customers. But yeah, we need to define that. It's well, a point well taken, Mr. Hardy. Any other comments?
Are there any other commissions or boards or town organizations that have a similar fund that would benefit from guidelines besides just the senior center?
The Smith-Harris House has their Friends of Smith-Harris. So their Samuel Smith House has a Friends group, I believe, a fundraising group to enhance town-owned buildings.
Library.
And the library as well.
But
has
I think it's
an
the
endowment.
Responsibility of that commission to to perhaps solidify or make more specific the guidelines. But, you know, they have angst over this, too. They know what they're doing the best they can. And they have some angst, and it was discussed at the meeting about, you know, are other boards and commissions expected to do this? And I say no.
Right.
They need a telephone. The town pays for it.
Yeah, it does. That seems nickel and dime, you know. That we're, I agree.
Could I ask a question, maybe, Vanna? If she decides to purchase this with funds in her regular budget, and it goes over, you know, could she come back? So if we say, take it out of the town, take it out of your budget. If you go over, come back for us. We could transfer some money from the another account, obviously the backup account. But can we do it that way, or do we have to have approval tonight so that she could purchase these phone lines? So there's not sufficient funds in that account. It's not that she'll just run over when she gets to maybe June 20th or something like that.
Yeah.
I guess that's my question.
We don't ask or expect our department heads to run their operations like that. So.
Yeah, that's my question.
Yeah, money's been appropriated. It has to be used appropriately.
Yep.
Because we have to be transparent with our spending. So and can't just make up projects in the middle of the year and start wiring buildings or whatever.
But there are some, in our budget lines, there are some maintenance lines and some things that are kind of up to the discretion of the heads, department heads.
I really feel long-term that because we have three or four different commissions or organizations, that I think the town needs to give them the guidelines on what should be a town paid responsibility, or what should be what's allowed by whatever donated funds, because some donations are made just with specific restrictions on them, what they should be used for. You know, someone could donate $500 to put your telephone in if they wanted to. So, and I don't know how you do it across the board. It's very tough, but
we do have to be singing from the same hymnal, that's for sure.
We're buying furniture for our space in the Waterford. Unfortunately, Senior Center's commission may not be able to buy a telephone to provide services, and that's a dichotomy that it is what it is, right? Yeah.
Well, I do want to be clear. I have the phone is being purchased out of operations. It's just that
just further creates we're buying a piece of the project from your budget, and the other piece is coming from your fund. It seems very inconsistent.
I suggest we approve this tonight. We could lower the amount. You know, I don't think $800 to wire this anyway.
We
could lower this amount. Right. We could approve this tonight. In the meantime, I could tap on Joe Bregaz. You know, he is Public Works, and we have maintenance of buildings and things like this. You know, if the line were to go dead tomorrow at my desk at the First Selectman's office, you know, we'd get it fixed. And there's got to be money for that.
Right.
And
maybe we wouldn't vote.
Or maybe I wouldn't get it fixed because the phone wouldn't work. We get it fixed. It's my job to answer the phone. So maybe we can find another solution based on Mrs. Hardy's suggestion. I'd like the progress of the project to go on, though, and I'd hold this up through appropriations and make this thing last I'd like the cogs of government to keep moving. Sometimes they slow down too much. So I'd suggest if we brought it down to 500, let's cut it in half. Let's cut it in half.
Well, she says up to, so she can return the money.
She wouldn't spend it anyway, right?
She can put the money back in the account.
Do you want to just go up to?
Yeah.
Okay. It already says up to.
In the meantime, I'd like to see if there is some time.
I mean to interrupt, but once the work is scheduled and performed, then we know exactly what type of money we're looking at.
Right.
And maybe it's $200.
This can't be a lot.
It can't be, but...
Yeah.
But that's not, nobody's giving me a call.
But again,
yet.
I go back to the example that I had at the department head meeting, that something that I thought was going to be $800 is $4,000.
You got it. I know.
So that project's on hold. Yeah.
This is a job that's going to be hourly. It's not somebody is not going to give you a quote.
No, it's a current staff member. We're just giving a professional space.
The installation of the phone line is where it's the vendor for the phone company. It's Sonatrol, so it would be hourly. Yeah.
Okay, so you don't know.
Yeah, I mean.
They won't give you a quote.
I mean.
Because they're not giving you a fixed firm price.
They come in and wire it.
Yeah.
Right.
Got it.
And if you've been in the attic, which I have.
Oh.
It's quite interesting.
Have you been up in the attic, Mrs. Hardy?
I have been up in the attic.
I knew the answer to that before you asked the question.
Had the building not been shortchanged and the basement was in the building, which should have been there, then I would have been in the basement too.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Hey, let's vote on this. I think yes, any further comment?
So is it going to be low at the $400? Is that what we heard? Or
I think we're going to keep
it up. It's up to. She'll spend it if need be. In the meantime, Anna and I will get to work with Mrs. Wilson, and we'll see if there's another way to pay for this through operations, as it probably should be. And point well taken, Mrs. Hardy.
Well, I'd like to make a commitment to make a donation for the purpose of installing the phone line at the senior center up to $500.
Well, I'm kind of embarrassed now.
You don't need to be. I really think
I'll second that.
And I really think the precedent of how the individual commissions and groups pay for hardcore facility-related items needs a little more guidance. And I think the service needs to be provided. And if the phone broke today, like you said, we'd fix it tomorrow and find a way. If you find a way to pay for the coverage through other things, fine. If not, my donation can be used for other things.
So you'd be donating it into the Parahouse account then?
Depending on the outcome, it'll be into the account. They can use it through the phone.
Okay.
If you cannot come up with a way to pay for it with other towns, or if they
that helps.
Other town budgets, then.
Thank you, Mr. Daigle.
Have I told you you're my favorite first selectman?
I already knew.
Thank you.
Very generous, Mr. Daigle, and solves a little bit of a problem, and puts your stipend to good use, doesn't it? Very worthy. I'll call for the motion then. All in favor of the motion, which is to approve up to
$850.
Say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstain?
Abstain.
Still abstain. Okay. Great. Spend Mr. Diggle's money wisely. Very generous, Mr. Diggle. And
thank you.
And we'll get to work on some clarifications too.
Okay.
In the future. Thank you for coming out tonight, Mrs. Wilson. You have a long day at the senior center, and I heard it was a good one today.
Oh, talking about public works, that's where I was today, the DOT ordering a vehicle, so I felt very public worky.
Okay. Public worky. The next is on our agenda is the discussion of possible action on Parks and Rec Department's request to consider a town ordinance to extend fines for walking dogs in the Niantic Boardwalk. We had a lot of discussion this evening. Overwhelmingly, people were in favor of this, with one exception, but that person, I think, also was not in favor of dogs on the boardwalk as much as relying on people's goodwill and common sense. Oh, dear. Any comments?
Put a motion out first. Mm-hmm. I'll move to adopt the amendment to the ordinance entitled Ordinance Concerning Areas Under Jurisdiction of Parks and Recreation Commission as submitted.
Second.
Motion's been made and seconded. Comments?
I think, first of all, commend town council for all the research they've done for this, for all the work Dave has done with this, with Parks and Rec, as well as his public works hat as well, I guess, tonight. So, yeah.
Hope Joe's not watching.
Hope Joe's not watching. You know, and the comment about the signage, that was one of the topics brought up last week at the Parks and Rec meeting, and that we need definitive signage that references state statutes and so forth like that, and much more legible. And I know Dave also talked about making sure his staff would not be confrontational. You ask, if they refused, you know, there's ways to deal with it in that case. And I know the concern about a fine, but a fine is a method of last resort. I would think in almost every case, if a person left voluntarily, it's not going to result in a fine. But I think that's, unfortunately, a needed tool if the person gets argumentative or it's a, you know, flagrant, inconsistent violation. And as we heard tonight, most people, even devout dog lovers, figure that that's really no place for a dog, unless it's, of course, a service dog, as we talked about. So I'm very comfortable with moving forward this, and based on the recommendation and request from Parks and Rec as well.
Any other comments?
I would concur with those sentiments, and unfortunately, this day and age, we need to have some sort of enforcement. I would request that on the signs, it spells that out, that it's a $50 fine. And I think people will start listening, because obviously, talking to people, this is a continuing problem. And it's getting more and more difficult these days for just normal people to even say something without getting an attitude back. And I think, unfortunately, we need to have a fine structure.
Comments?
I also agree with it. Is there any value, any practice regarding listing the ordinance on the sign in accordance with town ordinance? Give it a little, I don't know if that adds any value or doesn't add any value.
I think it does add value to have the ordinance on the sign. So
yeah.
The one sign out there is confusing. It's meant for the beaches and not for the boardwalk, and then people interpret it the way they want to interpret it. So it does have to be clear, and I think it is important to put the ordinance on the sign.
And my other comment was, I think the Parks and Recs Commission should go, Parks Commission should discuss the, not necessarily right away, but discuss whether it should be pedestrians only and service animals, or whether you want to use domestic animals. And I don't want to delay it, because it's that time of the year and it's something you can do, although I wouldn't want you to have to reprint signs either. So just give that some consideration. I'm not saying you should change from where we're at now, which is no dogs. But someone's going to show up with a cat and a carrier and a baby stroller, and someone's going to say, I'm okay to have a cat. And that's probably a little safer if it's in a walking in a baby stroller, but you're going to see it.
Yeah. The policies are crystal clear. The signs could be cleaned up a little bit and make our policies, communication clearer, and we'll do that. We'll make sure that that is effective and properly communicated. Any other comments? We'll take a vote. All in favor, say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstain? Terrific. Thank you, Mrs. Collins. Your services are valued and appreciated.
Thank you. Good night, Nick.
Discussion and possible action on the proposed lease for the communications tower on the Mostowy Road site.